This is a 2-mark question asked in GATE 2020 of ECE. This is from signal system subjects and from the DFT chapter and based on certain properties. The question is, a finite duration discrete time signal x of n is obtained by sampling the continuous time signal x of t equals to cos 200 pi t at sampling instant t equals to n by 400, where n takes the value from 0 to 7. The 8-point DFT of x of n is defined by the DFT standard equations. Then which one of the following is true? So basically, if you see the options, which samples of x of k are 0 is what they are asking, right? So how do you answer this question? So the concept involved in these problems are nothing new. They have asked multiple times in the previous papers, but two, three different things they have clubbed in a single problem. That is the only thing. So you know very well, if we have a signal x of t, then to get its discrete equivalent, so we used to replace the t by nts. So if the continuous time signal is x of t, then the discrete time signal is obtained by replacing t by nts. So x of n is equals to, so if I replace the t by nts, this is cos 200 pi nts. But anyway, they are telling here the sampling instant is t equals to n by 400. That is, so to get the corresponding discrete signal, so in this I am substituting the t equals to n by 400. So I will get cos of 200 pi and this is n by 400. So in these equations, I have substituted t equals to n by 400. So if I simplify this, so I am getting cos of pi by 2 n, where n takes the values 0 to 7. So let us substitute them and let's see what you are getting, because x of n is a finite duration signal, right? If I put here n equal to 0, I get cos 0, and if I put n equals to 1, I get cos pi by 2. If I put n equals to 2, I get cos pi. If I put 3, I get cos 3 pi by 2. If I put 4, I get cos 2 pi. If I put 5, I get cos 5 pi by 2. If I put 6, I get cos 3 pi. If I put 7, I get cos 7 pi by 2. And I believe, you know, cos n pi by 2 is equals to 0 for odd n. Cos pi by 2, 3 pi by 2, 5 pi by 2, they are all 0. Similarly, cos n pi is given by minus 1 power n. So like if n takes the even value, you get it is 1. If n takes the odd value, you get it is minus 1. So it means when even n, you get 1. For odd n, you get minus 1. So if I am, you know, getting the sample of this, cos 0 is 1, cos pi by 2 is 0, cos pi is minus 1, cos 3 pi by 2 is 0, cos 2 pi is 1, cos pi by 2 is 0, cos 3 pi is minus 1, cos 7 pi by 2 is 0. So this is the signal x of n, right? And they are asking us to find the DFT. So if you find the DFT, then we can find which of the samples of DFT are becoming 0, right? So one way to find the DFT of this one is you use the completely that DFT standard equations and you solve it. But if you see the options, there is no way to eliminate some options. So this, finding the DFT by that two for 8 samples, it's not a, it will take a good amount of time, right? So it's a time consuming job. So we have to find it a way that how to avoid the intermediate calculations. So for this, what I'm doing is, suppose I'm defining a signal, this is what x of n we have. So suppose I'm defining a signal which is y of n. So y of n is, let's say, I'm defining this is 1 minus 1, 1 minus 1. 1 minus 1, 1 minus 1, this is what I'm defining x of n. Then if I ask you, what is y of n by 2, what do you get? So basically, I want to interpolate the signal by 2. So if you interpolate the signal by 2, so like, I hope you know this. If I have a signal y of n, if I want to have y of n minus k, then after each sample, I have to add k minus 1 number of 0. I have to attach k minus 1 number of zeros after each samples. So here the k factor is 2, so 2 minus 1 is 1. So if you have y of n, to get y of n by 2, you have to attach 1 0 after each sample. So you get 1 0, minus 1 0, 1 0 and minus 1 0. Isn't it? Now why I am doing like this? This y of n by 2 is nothing but equals to this x of n. You see 1 0 minus 1 0 1, 0 minus 1 0. This is the same pattern. So this is what your x of n is. So this is what your x of n is. So what is the job we can do is, so instead of finding the 8-point DFT of this signal, let us first find the DFT of this, and then there are your properties. The DFT property like this. Suppose for example, if y of n having DFT y of k, okay, then y of n minus, sorry, n by m will have DFT y of k, comma y of k, comma y of k, dot 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 m times. It means if you know the DFT of y of n, if that signal is interpolated by a factor m, in the DFT you have to copy that DFT m times. So if I take m equal to 2, then it means y of n by 2 will have the DFT y of k, comma y of k. Only 2 times. So basically, once if I know the DFT of this, then to get DFT of this, I just have to copy that y of k once more. And from there itself, we can see which samples are 0, which samples are non-zero. So basically, what we are trying to do is to make our job simple. So I am just trying to find the DFT of this, and then by finding the DFT of this by property, rather than directly finding the DFT of this. And to find the DFT of a, 4-point samples, it's a very easy task. You have a standard matrix. I believe you all of you know that matrix, right? So let us solve that. So I believe we can, you have copied this. So I need some space. So y of k is given by the 4 plus 4 matrix. 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, and 1. And then here you have this 1 again. Then this is minus 1. This is minus 1. This is minus 1. This is minus 1. This is minus j. This is minus j. This is j. And this is j. Okay, this is the W matrix, and with this, this is what I want to find the DFT of this. So this is 1, this is minus 1, this is 1, and this is minus 1. So if you multiply these two, you will get the DFT y of k. So this is a 4 cross 4 matrix, and this is a 4 cross 1 matrix. So the result of this, this will be a 4 cross 1 matrix, or a column vector. So how to get these samples? So this row should be multiplied with these things. 1 into 1 is 1, plus 1 into minus 1 is minus 1, plus 1 into 1 is 1, plus 1 into minus 1 is minus 1. So this is coming 0, isn't it? Similarly, if you want to get these samples, so again multiply this row with this column. 1 into 1 is 1, minus j into minus 1 is plus j. Then minus 1 into minus 1 is, minus 1 into 1 is minus 1. And we have plus j with minus j, plus j with minus 1 is minus j. So this is also being cancelled out. So you again get it is 0. Third row with this, if I multiply, 1 into 1 is 1, minus 1 into minus 1 is plus 1, 1 into 1 is 1, minus 1 into minus 1 is plus 1. So here I am getting it is 4. The last row, if I see, I get 1, minus j, minus 1, and plus j. So again, this is becoming 0. 0, 0, 4, 0. Right? So, if y of n is this, then y of k, what I am getting is 0, 0, 4, 0. This is y of k. So, if y of n is this, this is y of k. Then, if this is what x of n, which is y of n by 2. What is the DFT of this? So this is y of k comma y of k. Because the interpolation factor is 2, the y of k should be copied 2 times. So I have to just write this y of k twice. So I will get 0, 0, 4, 0, 0, 0, 4 and 0. Okay? So this is what the DFT of x of n. So if this is what x of n is, then the its DFT x of k is 0, 0, 4, 0, 0, 0, 4, 0. Okay. Now they are asking which of the samples are non-zero. So this is what k equal to 0, this is k equal to 7. So non-zero samples are this and this. So this is x of 0, x of 1, this is x of 2, x of 3, x of 4, x of 5 and this is x of 6. So out of the 8 samples, only x of 2 and x of 6 are non-zero and remaining all samples are 0. In fact, I think in 2016 there is a problem where they have asked some ratio of x of 6 to x of 11, a mod of that they have asked. So there also this property they have asked. The same thing they have asked again but by clubbing with 2-3 concepts, right? The main thing is in this problem is conceptually there is nothing new in these problems, but the only thing is how to avoid the calculations. If some of you might be, you know, knowing this particular properties, finding this DFT is not a very complicated job. Because I have explained you this problem from scratch and each and every step I have taken around 10-12 minutes of time, but if you solve in a flow, this is not more than 4-5 minute job. And in every papers, certain questions are a bit lengthy and this is also a bit lengthy problems. So anyway, the answer is only x of 2 and x of 6 are non-zero.